Hello, I'm Sonic. We are now ready for the next part. Here, logarithmic functions can be additive or subtractive. Consider this first identity. Log x plus log y, which is equal to log xy. This is because, if you are adding log x and log y, which is multiplicative of log xy. Second identity, log x minus log y, which is equal to log x by y. If you are subtracting from log x and log y, then this is the division of log x by y. Third identity, log x to the exponent y, is equal to y log x, where y was the exponent, and it's transformed into standard value of y, depending on the multiple of a number. Fourth identity, the log of square root x, or you can mean, x to the 1 by 2 exponent, is equal to half times log x. This is same as the third identity which we have tried. Fifth identity, with y root, or x to the 1 by y exponent, is logarithm x in numerator, divided by y in the denominator. And finally sixth identity, we make some variations of log values. We know, log of 1 is 0, and log 0 is undefined in the negative y-axis. Now, log of minus 1, this is slightly tricky. Domain of the log x function is only positive numbers, it is not defined for negative values, and when x tends to 0 the value of log x tends to minus infinity. You could see that x is always greater than 0. Hence log, minus 1, is not defined, but there is one possible value, 1.364i, where I represents the imaginary complex number. Now, are these possible logarithmic values such as x plus y, or x minus y in the parenthesis? Well, definitely not, because operators plus or minus in the parenthesis is not even possible. So you now know how to use logarithmic functions. Like, comment, and subscribe now.